Hello guys, I am Tushar Malu, the drivetrain and aerodynamics head of Bitsco Racing, and today I'll be taking you through the major parts of drivetrain assembly and its components. Firstly, we'll be looking at the types of drivetrain. We have four types of drivetrain available in the market. First is front wheel drive, second is rear wheel drive, then all wheel drive, and lastly four wheel drive. So the first image here shows the front wheel drive for the drivetrain system. In the front wheel drive, the power from the engine is transmitted via the transmission to the front wheels of the car. As you can see, here is the engine and the transaxle system of the car, and then the power is transmitted to the front tires of the car. Secondly, we come to the rear wheel drive of the car. Here, the engine transmits the power to the rear wheels of the car. As you can see, clearly the engine via the transmission and drive shaft, the power goes on to the rear wheels of the car. Now coming to the all-wheel drive and the four-wheel drive. The all-wheel drive system is shown over here, as you can see by my cursor. Here, all the four wheels of the vehicle are powered by the engine, whereas in a four-wheel drive is a slightly different from the all-wheel drive. In four-wheel drive, you can partially make it a two-wheel drive too, as seen in the two figures here, the part-time four-wheel drive and the full-time four-wheel drive. Moving on to the next part, that is the components of the drivetrain. The components of the drivetrain are mainly the gearbox, which is attached with the engine, then the front drive shaft and the rear drive shaft, and lastly, a differential and the half shafts behind. This diagram here shows the rear wheel drive of a car, where the power from the engine is transmitted to the back end of the car, and it is and with the differential, it is transmitted to either side of the car vehicle. Here, some of the components you can see are front drive shaft, tripod CV joints, single guardian universal joints, rear differential, then rear tripod joint, left rear half shaft, and many more. Now, moving to our first component, that is the gearbox of the system. There are various types of gearbox in a car, mainly the manual gearbox, the diagram for which is shown here, and the continuously variable transmission, that is CVT. Now I'll be taking upon the manual gearbox, where this golden shaft here gets the input power from the engine, and here at the end the silver shaft gives the output power. In the manual gearbox, there's various combinations of gears, as you can see. So here is the first gear, then second, then there is third gear over here, then there is fourth gear, fifth, sixth, and seventh, and lastly the reverse gear over here. So the help of the gearbox shifter in our cars, we can change the positions of the gearbox over here. There is also a clutch assembly in the initial stages of the gearbox here. Here you can see there are two clutch, which helps to disengage the gearbox when we are trying to change gears manually. Now coming on to the continuously variable transmission. Here there are two pulley systems. You can see one over here and other one over here where I have shown the cursor. The two pulleys change the radius constantly. So you can imagine a pulley to be shaped like this, and then as per the needs, it either moves out or then it moves in, thereby changing the radius continuously as and when required. So when both the pulleys perform the same operation, infinite number of ratio is achieved due to this type of transmission. This is also a very complex transmission, and it requires a certain amount of electronic circuitry to help it do the same. And in the bottom left, you can see the diagrammatic representation of the manual engine over here. So here with the shift, we can move the gears as and when required, and the clutch helps us to do that. Now coming to the next component, that is the differential. The differential as seen before is in the back end of the car. Here you can see this is the differential case over here. Now the differential is a crucial part of the drivetrain system. It delivers uneven power to right or the left side of the car. Now I'll be explaining why we need that. Suppose in case one of the tires, that is the right or the left tire, is slipping on the road due to some water or slug or some puddle. So we need the power or the torque on the other end of the car to move it forward. A differential comes in very handy in such situations and helps us move ahead. So here is the input shaft for the differential, and then here is the left and the right shaft. In the following GIF in the bottom here, you can see a normal differential when there is no there is a 50-50 load transfer between left and right. But due to certain changes, as you can see, one of the sides is moving faster than the other. This shows that the differential is performing correctly. Now there is one more type of differential, the limited slip differential, as compared to the open differential. Here you have a S-shaped spring in between to maintain the discs, that is the clutch discs over here, compressed. So this is an advanced type of open differential where it covers more cases than the normal one. And this is a type of differential which you can see in our day-to-day lives in our car. Now coming to the next section, that is the constant velocity joint, CV joint. These joints are very crucial for a drivetrain because it sets the input and output shaft at different angles. As you can see on the right hand side, there's tripod CV joint, and on the left hand side, we have RZEPA CV joint. Here you can see, considering this as the input shaft and this as the output shaft, we can see some sort of an obtuse angle formed here rather than a straight 180 degree angle. So this helps the power transmission to be transmitted at a different angle as per the requirement. And since the name suggests, it maintains the constant velocity in both the shafts. Now, finally, this is the last segment where I'll be discussing the formula shown in drivetrain component in the FSA car that we have built. So here you can see the chassis is the green and the yellow rods. And this differential assembly, this is the differential assembly which is mounted on it. Now the black part over here shows the engine, and here there is a front sprocket of the engine, and this is the rear sprocket, and the rear sprocket is attached onto the differential via bolts, and then internally the differential is connected with constant velocity joint. On the right hand side you can see a little bit exploded diagram over here where the power from the engine is in this shaft which is connected to a smaller sprocket over here. And this is the largest sprocket over here. So this is connected to each other by chain mechanism. There is also belt mechanism and rod, but the most efficient one in FSA causes this. And thus power from the engine is transmitted here to the differential. And then it is transferred to the wheels via the constant velocity joint and the half shaft over here. So these are the major components of our drivetrain assembly where you will find common in all the vehicles. Thank you.